breakouts on your chest or on your back, your arms, your face. You begin to suffer from acne, dryness of skin because you are over exfoliating your skin. There are soaps, you know, that are not meant to be used every day, especially when it is. Hello, lovely people. How are you all doing? It's been a wonderful week. I have been away from home, but from my setup, you know that I'm already back to base. It was a marvelous time when I was out of station. My name is Marie, just in case this is your first time. If you're a new subscriber, thank you for becoming a part of the family. You are appreciated. Thank you for your subscription. If you're an old subscriber, thank you for always watching my uploads. Now today, I am going to be sharing a tip with you. Actually, the video is going to be in two parts. So you're going to see me wear the same thing I'm wearing now in the part two. In this part, I'm going to be sharing a tip with you on how to make your creams work even better. You know, it's not all of the time that you think you should change your cream because it's not working and blah blah blah. So if you're interested in this video, please keep watching. Like I said, this video is going to be on beauty tips on how to make your creams work even faster. It's not all of the time that the cream you're using stops working. Sometimes it's the things you are not doing that makes it appear as though your creams are not working. By the time I'm done with these few tips that I'm going to be sharing with you, I know that you will experience that your creams are working better, you will get faster results, and of course you will have glowing skin. Number one tip I want to share with you today is that you've got to use sunscreens. If you're using skin lightening agents, using skin lightening creams, and your skin starts to glow and to shine, of course you need to protect your skin. Sunscreens, whatever variety you choose to use, there are varieties in the market, but whatever brand you choose to use, be sure that it's the type that contains SPF of 50 and above or 30 and above. What this goes to do for you is to ensure that the skin does not damage your skin, and then your skin does not get unnecessarily damaged by the UV rays that are you know, transmitted into the skin. While you can still get the full benefits of walking in the sun, maybe going sunbathing or just walking in the sun or doing your thing, you know, so that your skin does not get damaged. For instance, your face could get much darker if you do not use sunscreen. Sunscreens goes to protect the layer of the face and of the body so that the UV rays do not damage your skin. And you know, sometimes when the sun is too much, it does cause skin cancer. So using that sunscreen, especially on your face and your neck, goes a long way to help you maintain your glow, and then you see better and faster results with the creams that you're using. Tip number two, wear sunglasses when you're out in the sun. Why should you wear sunglasses? It helps to protect your eyes and protect the delicate areas around the eyes. You know, the areas of the eyes do not have as much fat as other parts of the face. And then the layer of the skin there is very soft, very delicate. So when you wear sunglasses, it does protect your eye circle area from being darkened and being damaged too. And then you begin to have wrinkles and all that. The sunglasses does help protect your eyes first, and then protect the delicate area, the skin around the eyes, so that you do not get wrinkles and sense of aging around that part of your face. Also, you could wear hats. You could wear hats to protect your skin. You could to protect the face. You could wear your hats, and then you could use umbrellas also to avoid the unnecessary harshness of the sun, so that your delicate skin is protected by that shade that you carry around. With you, to protect your skin from excess sun rays. Before you apply creams to your skin, always bathe your body with soap and water and a sponge. A lot of people use towels to have their bath. I think that is not good enough. I think that the bare hand on the towel cannot exactly exfoliate your skin and help remove the dead surface of the skin that darkens the body. When you use soap and sponge, and it does not have to be an exfoliating soap, it could be a tablet soap. For instance, I like Imperial Leather. I like to use Imperial Leather a lot, even though I have other brands of soap. Is that my camera just went off in a moment. But hey, you've got to use soap, sponge, and water. It does not have to be an exfoliating soap. It could just be a beauty soap, you know, a toilet soap that could lather very well and help wash out grease and, you know, sebum that the skin secretes to help protect the dermis from damage. So you that would happen. And then of course you also put cream on your body or oil on your body, as the case may be. The beautiful thing about bathing your body with sponge and soap and water is that it helps to remove the dead layers of the skin. The towel, in my opinion, does not clean the skin very well. And when we talk about sponge, do something that is netty, something firmish that could scrub the body and not foam, because there are people that use foams to have their bath. They call that sponge. Foam is not sponge, and sponge is not foam. So you've got to use something that can scrub the surface of the body and help remove that layer of the skin of the body that you want to clean away. So adequately washing your body would help your properties. Whatever cream you're using, it will help it to work better. You will see your skin glowing after bath, and of course, with either warm water. There are people that do not like to use cold water. If you use excessive hot water, it will damage the surface layer of your skin and wrinkle up your skin. But when you use the cool water or tepid water or slightly warm water, you would find that your skin will respond very well to it and receive it very well. That would help to moisturize your skin, because the skin does absorb water when you bathe. Yes, you may just be hearing that for the first time, but of course, your skin does absorb water when you bathe yourself, and helps the dermis to absorb water and get moisturized and plump up a bit, you know, so that it's able to receive the after treatment of your bathing. It's such a fantastic thing when you take good care of your skin, and then your cream works faster and better. It's always appropriate that before bedtime, especially when you use creams that are of high quality or contain active ingredients that are meant to be used in the night time. They are not for the day, so don't use them for the day. If you want your creams to work better, use them at night just before bed. Of course, having done all those things that we talked about, then you go ahead and apply your creams and you go to bed. You're going to make a success of having a glowing. Sometimes when you use certain products, you find out that you have breakouts on your chest or on your back, your arms, your face. You begin to suffer from acne, dryness of skin, because you are over exfoliating your skin. There are soaps, you know, that are not meant to be used every day, especially when it is written on it that it is an exfoliating soap. You do not use an exfoliating soap every day. You use that your exfoliating soap twice a week. Otherwise, your skin is going to be damaged. Then suddenly you find out that you're using a product and then you're beginning to have acne breakout on your face, on your body. It's because you are over peeling your skin. Exfoliating is peeling of the skin. And if you overdo that, you're going to expose your tender skin that's not yet ready to be exposed to the sun, thereby suffering the effect of acne breakout. So what do I suggest to you? Use your exfoliating soap just twice a week and give 3 days or 4 days in between. That is the best thing you can do in using your exfoliating soap. Thank you for watching this video. Like I said, I will see you in the part 2 of this video. Don't go away.